there is a multitude of metrics and reports that are associated with Agile and Scrum, but often they're used in the wrong way and sometimes not used at all. Let's review what useful metrics and relevant graphs you can implement in your team to track progress and improve. Hey, it's Daria here. Welcome. Let's build some awesome teams. In this video, I'd like to talk about some agile metrics, or more specifically, about some graphs and visualization reports that can be extremely useful in certain situations. I'll also do a quick overview of what Jira has to offer, since it's a very popular tool used by so many teams. An important disclaimer, everything I will be talking about in this video is not mandatory for Scrum teams. These are just complementary practices you may decide to use. Don't implement them in your team if there is no need for them. I've already talked about velocity in my previous videos, such as this one. So if you are completely new to the topic of velocity and have no idea how it is usually calculated and used, I recommend you check out this video first and then come back here. I will be using metrics such as velocity to help me create the reports here. But before I do, remember to subscribe to this YouTube channel if you're not subscribed yet, and give this video a thumbs up if you like it. And check out my store for more guides and templates for Scrum Masters and Scrum Teams. Okay, Scrum Team reports. There are three key reports I'd like to talk about here. Velocity chart, Burndown and Burnup chart, cycle time and control chart. Velocity chart. Let's look into how this is presented in Jira to help us out in a visual way. Here you can see two numbers tracked: committed story points and completed ones, sprint after sprints. Committed points show how much work the team thought they would complete in a sprint. They committed to delivering that amount of points to do their best to do as much work. Completed shows the actual work that has been completed, the story points that have been put into done. How should you read this graph in such a way that is helpful for your team? Firstly, you should expect variations in the numbers. Those are absolutely normal and should not be immediately considered as a cause for alarm. Committed versus completed points will rarely be the same, but it can give you some insights into how well the team is planning. Do they have a tendency to overcommit, as in take in too much work at the beginning of the sprint, but only complete a small amount? Or the other way around, do they have a tendency to undercommit and have to add new work during the sprint all the time? These questions can give you some good improvement opportunities that you can discuss in a retro. If the completed points jump up and down a lot, it can give you some discussion points as well. For example, in Sprint 5 here, there was a huge dip in the number of points completed. Some questions to ask here: what happened to cause this decrease? Was it a one-off issue or something we need to be wary of in the future? How can we avoid it? It may be something not to worry about, like end of year holidays when most of the team was on vacation, so naturally the team was not able to accomplish as much work as usual. Or maybe on the contrary, that highlights a big impediment that the team needs to help resolving. It's just that it happened more specifically in Sprint 5, but we know it's going to come up later. Burndown chart. So burndown charts can be quite useful for forecasting. Usually, they are used within a sprint by the team to show progress towards the end of the sprint. It can show how likely the team will be able to complete the work based on the progress. It can highlight issues early on and to allow the team to adapt to them, to adapt their sprint backlog accordingly, because they were able to detect those issues early. Here on this graph, you can see progress day by day. The team has started on the first day with 17.5 points of work and completed 2.5 points on the first day. On the next 2 days, they didn't complete anything as the line is flat. Then on September 6th, they completed 5 points. we can see how close they are to the ideal line, the gray one. Fluctuations are normal, of course, as usual. It might happen that on the first couple of days, the orange line goes up as the team adds more work into their sprint backlog instead of burning through it. That's also normal behavior, since as the team starts working on something, they will discover new information that may impact the amount of work in the sprint. Maybe some of the tasks that they didn't see while planning that came up as they started working. Unfortunately, Jira is not doing a really good tracking here because it doesn't track subtasks and only tracks tickets on the level of user stories, bugs, and tasks. So it may be difficult to actually track the progress more closely to subtasks on a day-to-day basis. However, it still has the graph that you can use. Your team will need to spend some extra time on splitting work into smaller pieces, in this case, to really get the most benefit from the burndown charts in Jira. It is a great practice in general to split user stories and tickets into smaller pieces of work that you should definitely work on with your team anyway. So why not do it in order to be able to use charts like the burndown chart to help the team track their progress. Otherwise, if you have huge product backlog items that take half a sprint to complete, you'll have a flat line all the way through the first half of the sprint because nothing is completed yet. This information is not very helpful. In addition, the team needs to be very diligent in updating the status of their work day to day, or the same way, the graph will be absolutely useless. One important point I want to make here, sprint burndown chart is not something a Scrum Master tracks and updates. It is a tool developers may decide to use to help them track their progress. However, you can also use the burndown chart on the level of a release or an epic. It's basically the same as with the tasks in sprint burndown, but you look at a longer period of time and bigger scope. You can use this burndown charts in your sprint reviews or anytime when talking with stakeholders. It can also easily show progress towards goals and give a general idea if the team is on track or some changes to scope or dates are needed. There are graphs provided by Jira that I absolutely love, but I haven't seen them used anywhere else. So I'm not sure if other tools provide something similar, but I want to share them here just to give you an idea of what you can do as well. Maybe manually. They may seem a bit confusing at first, but once you get them, they can provide a lot of valuable information. So you can see that the work is burning down the same way on this graph with the line that we looked at previously. However, it is more visual and clear. The biggest difference is if work is being added, it doesn't make the line go up as we discussed earlier. Instead, it adds it to the bottom. This means that we have more to burn down through before we get to the bottom. Like here in sprint 2, 5 story points were added. The same happened in sprint 3 and 4. The green part shows how many story points were completed in each sprint, and the rest is everything else we yet need to do. Why I love this graph is because it can give you forecasts. For example, here it says that based on team's velocity for the last 3 sprints, they'll need one more sprint to complete everything. This is just a forecast, not a guarantee. Burnup charts. The burnup chart is kind of the opposite of the burndown, so I put it in the same category. Just instead of going down, we're going up, obviously. It can easily show the work added by moving the top orange line, or if it is removed, the line goes down. Our goal is to get the orange and the green lines to meet at the very end, usually by a certain date that can be set up in Jira, for example. But as we know, when we work in a complex environment, our forecasts will need to be updated regularly as we learn more. Whatever chart you're using, whatever metric you're using for forecasts, always remember that it's just a forecast. A plan that isn't perfect, we'll need to go back to it as soon as we learn something new, as soon as we know more about our progress towards goals, and we'll need to adapt it. So it's more about giving more visual information to everyone rather than giving guarantees or trying to create a perfect plan with exact deadlines that the team will be able to meet. We can't do that in a complex environment. We just have too many factors that will impact the work of our team. Anyway, cycle time and control chart. So cycle time is another useful metric. It basically means how much time it takes on average between starting the work and completing the work item. How long does it take for a product backlog item to get from first being marked in progress to done? This can be very useful in identifying whether your team needs to spend more time on refinement and highlight other improvement opportunities. Actually, I'd say even without calculating cycle time, your team most likely needs to spend more time on refinement anyway, because 99.9% of teams do. So don't wait for calculating cycle time before you start helping your team be more productive in their refinements. But as we talk about cycle time, ask yourself this question. How does cycle time compare to our sprint length? For example, if your sprint is 2 weeks long and your average cycle time is 20 days, that can be a big red flag. It means that the team on average is not able to complete a work item within one sprint, almost ever. Or if your cycle time is 7 days for a 2 week sprint, it might be cutting it a bit too close for comfort. The risk of not being able to complete the work item are much higher if they take almost the whole sprint. In this case, your team needs to spend more time on splitting work into smaller batches. Or on the contrary, if your project management software is showing you that your cycle time is something completely ridiculous, like 1 hour, it most likely means that the team creates the work items once they are already done. That's a bit concerning because this work is not being tracked properly, and you should definitely address it. Jira provides a handy control chart that uses cycle time to create some forecasts. Again, it looks a bit scary when you first open it, but just focus on the information you actually need and ignore everything else. So here, the red line shows you the average cycle time. On this graph, it seems to be around 11 days. The blue line shows the average based on the smaller amount of work items, so I'd say it is closer to reality. It just takes a set of items around the same period of time to give you a better understanding of the cycle time during that period of time. Ask yourself, how is the blue line trending? Are we getting better and reducing cycle time or not? But then what you should look at are the green dots and highlight any stragglers that are sitting far away from the average. Here's where you can do some analysis. What happened with these work items that it took 200 days to complete them when the average cycle time is 11 days? Like for example, on this graph. What can be done to avoid creating work items like this in the future? So those are some of the great questions you can ask yourself when you look at different charts and metrics working with your team. And I think that will be it for this video. There are many more Agile metrics that you can use with your team and many more graphs and reports that are available. And I have a whole section of videos on this topic in my blog that I'm going to link in the description. I also have an essential guide called Measuring Scrum Team Performance. There, I share over 40 specific examples of metrics you can collect in relation to your product, team dynamics, and processes. It also comes with several metric visualization templates in a PowerPoint format. As always, link in the description. Anyway, to summarize what we talked about today, you can use Velocity Chart to help your team in planning. You can use the Burndown or Burnup charts to see real-time progress towards goals. And you can use the cycle time and control chart to highlight issues related to the team processes. I hope you learned something new today, and if you did, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this YouTube channel for more content like this. And leave me a comment down below. Share what are some of the metrics and reports that you like using, whether you're using Jira or not. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers and Scrum on.